4 plus 4 is 17. If he tell that baby that, that baby gonna say 4 plus 4 is 17. Cause it's learning. We're learning right now. But guess what? We learning. We have the ability to get the right information, and then we have the ability to get the wrong information. God say, don't be like that no more. You can't be that naive child no more, because you got more sense than that. Read.
And carry about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men.
Hold on. Read that again. Start over from the top.
Ephesians 4, verse 14. That we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro.
So he said, you can't be like children no more, going back and forth. Man, that Bible real. Man, this Bible ain't real. Oh man, that's the white man book, but I believe in God. He said, you can't be like that no more. You got to, bruh, you got to solidify yourself. You got to stay yourself. You got to get, okay, this what it say, I believe in this. This what I'm finna do. Read.
And carry about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of man.
So man is trying to trick you. Man is trying to get you to throw away your lottery ticket. Because remember, he said once you humble yourself and accept the punishment, then he gonna remember the covenant. The covenant is the lottery. That's the ticket. That's the $1 million. The kingdom of heaven is the prize. You gonna get that once you say, okay, God said do this, I'ma do this. God said do this, I'ma do this. Right? So man is trying to trick you. Psalms 83. Because you gotta understand now that there are people that want to trick you. So if you was out here, just say, for instance, you sell socks, right? Now, somebody come up to your stand where you sell your socks, and they trying to find a way to hustle you out your socks. Do you consider that person a friend now? Like, if that person come up, and they walking up, and they trying to take the socks on the low, they balling socks up in their hand, trying to take a sock, or they coming up and they like, ah man, your socks, these some sorry socks, these ain't no, you know what I'm saying? Are you gonna count them as a friend? Nah, bro, are you gonna count somebody trying to steal your lottery ticket as a friend?
No.
Read it. Psalms 83.
Psalms 83, verse 1.
Bring it out.
Keep not thou silence, O God.
All right, so this is King David, and this is what his prayers is. This is what his inner thoughts is. He asked God, don't keep silent. Don't let them just keep doing me like they trying to do me. You understand? That's what he's saying. Come on.
Hold not thy peace.
He's like, man, get them. Don't, you know what I'm saying? Help me out. This is essentially what we would be saying in modern terms. Like, God, don't just help me out. Don't be quiet no more. They don't believe you. They trying to do me something bad. Help me out. Come on.
And be not still, oh God.
Hold on. So you know your nationality, bro? All right, so what you got to do, though, because remember, we trying to help our people get this lottery ticket, bruh. What you got to do to get this lottery ticket? Hold that.
Yes, Mom.
Yeah, 10 and 12. Because Ecclesiastes 12, that's why. The whole duty of man. So, you know, we got to have in our mind first, before you leave here, you got to at least have the basics in your mind of what you need to do. So when you leave here, you don't go right back to what you was doing prior, you know what I'm saying, to this moment. That now you have a sense of what you got to do in your mind. Come on.
Ecclesiastes 12, verse 13.
Bring it out.
Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter.
So God say, this is the end. Listen to the whole thing. Listen to the conclusion, the end of the story. Listen to what you got to do. This is the final word on what you got to do. Come on.
Fear God.
You got to be afraid of God. You have to be afraid of his judgments. You have to be afraid of disappointing him. You got to be afraid of dying here.
That's right.
Right? Come on.
And keep his commandments.
So now you got to learn to keep God's commandments. One of his commandments is keep the Sabbath day holy. Get that right quick. You got, before you leave, these things that you got to start putting in your mind. I'm going to give you two real quick so that you can know, hey, when you leave here, next Saturday, you're going to be like, okay, I got to remember this. Read.
Exodus 20, verse 8.
Bring it out.
Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
God said, you have to remember this. This is a part of humbling yourself down and accepting the situation. The situation is I've been breaking God's commandments, so I'm in the hood. I live in the hood. I got roaches in my apartment. I try to act like I don't, but I do. I try to keep it clean, but it's hard. You know what I'm saying? I might be on some public assistance. My baby mama got food stamps. I got all that. Guess what? All this is a part of the punishment. You got to accept the punishment first. And the first thing you got to do once you accept the punishment is apologize for what you did and then stop doing it. That's like you get in trouble for cursing and you in the house. You can't keep walking around the house, keep cursing and expecting your mama, your dad to let you all punish you. You got to stop cursing, right?
Read.
6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work.
Guess what? Sunday through Friday, hustle hard. Bruh, if you got to run a 16, 17 hour day, Sunday through Friday, hustle. Do what you got to do. Work. Don't be doing nothing illegal because now you're going to put yourself in more sin. But if you got to work, then work. Work Sunday. Work Monday. Work Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Work Friday. But guess what? Friday, the 6 day.
Read.
But the seventh day.
The seventh day, which is today. Today is the seventh day, right? And see, according to God, we have to know that days start at nighttime. When the day is over once the sun go down. Ain't no more daylight, right? That's the beginning of a new day. At evening is the beginning of a new day, right? So Friday night, you need to be quit working. All right, Friday night is over. I'm done. I ain't working no more. Just Saturday night. If you need to go to work Saturday after the sun go down, then guess what? You can go to work Saturday after the sun go down. But guess what? Friday when the sun go down, to Saturday when the sun go down, you need to be keeping God's Sabbath day holy. Because that's a part of what got us in trouble. We act like it ain't, God don't care, he know my heart. God say no. What God say?
But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. In it thou shalt not do any work.
So he said you ain't supposed to do no work. And guess what go into work? Buying, selling. Because if you go to a store, what they doing in the store? They working. You making them work. Read.
Thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, thy manservant, nor thy maidservant.
Say, guess what? God say, your son, your daughter, if in our land, we had people that work for us, so now you would call them an employee. Your employee's not supposed to work. You're not supposed to do no work. Brother, what's your nationality? You from Nicaragua? What that say? That's Zebulon? Yeah, it is. Between the hills. Nicaragua. This Central America. Look. Guatemala. Right. To Panama. Not Guatemala and Panama. Everything in between. You in between. Right. So you would be from the tribe of Zebulon.
That's right.
Your people go through the same exact oppression as the so-called black man, as the so-called Native American man. Your people go through the same oppression. Right. Hey, your people was marching and walking here from a long way ago too. They was in the middle of the caravan. Why? Ain't no food, ain't no work, ain't no money. So guess what? Gang violence, people terrorized, they trying to get all the cocaine they could get up out of Nicaragua. So guess what? Your people going through the same oppression because they push cocaine on your people to make it so that these white people can use it. So guess what? Your people are oppressed by that. Now you got the cartels and the different factions that's trying to manufacture it, and it's putting your people in danger. But guess what? You ain't doing it for yourself. Your people will probably just chew the leaf and work. Guess what? Now you gotta stomp it, chew it, mix it up, be in the middle of the woods trying not to get caught so you can block it up so somebody else, and you doing it all for them. God said, you're gonna serve this other nation. You serving the other nation right now, and your people are serving another nation for everything they need. The dope is probably like the biggest commodity coming out of that area. It's the biggest commodity. They don't care nothing about no mangoes and plums. They want cocaine. And your people work and slave and get abused for cocaine. And then the ones who got the money kill the other one who trying to come up off the cocaine. Bro, that's oppressive.
Right.
Guess what? But that happened to the children of Israel.
That's right.
That happened to the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. And that's what we out here teaching our people, because we have to come back to who God said we was. You dropped part of your flyer. You know what I'm saying? So we have to do that. So, like, when the people was coming up this way, walking in the caravans, what did your people have to say about that? Brother, don't throw away that paper and forget your nationality, bro. That's what we got to come back to, all right? All right. Go back, Psalms 83.
Psalms 83, verse 1. Keep not thou silence, O God. Hold not thy peace. And be not still, O God, for lo, thine enemies make a tumult.
So guess what? We around people, our enemies, and they making a big old ruckus. They making a lot of noise. Read.
And they that hate thee.
So it's people out here that hate God. You know, we like to say God don't hate, but guess what? It's people that hate God. So if it's somebody that hate God and you love God, what do they think about you? They hate you. So-called black man, it's people out here that don't love God, bro, and they hate God, and they hate you in return. Read.
And they that hate thee have lifted up the head. Uh-huh. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
So he said, those that hate you have lifted up the head. That means they braggadocious right now. They done lift their head up. That means they bigoted. They arrogant right now. The enemies of God are arrogant right now. You know what I'm saying? They feel like they winning. They like, yeah, you know, we got something on these suckers now. Really?
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
You know, sister, you understand? You know what crafty counsel is? You don't know what crafty counsel is? I give you an easy definition. Trickery. Like. Slickness. Yeah, like somebody being slick. Like, you ever seen somebody got the ball game with the three caps? And then you know every time it's time for you to win some kind of way, they do something and you always lose and they get the money? That's sneaky. That's crafty counsel. God said his enemies are sneaky. They being sneaky right now. Guess what they doing to being sneaky? Telling you that you just black. Telling you can do what you want to do and love who you love, and it is what it is, and God love everybody. That's crafty counsel, because God ain't said that. Like, say for instance, you told your little boy, don't eat pineapples because you're allergic. And then he go to school, and some little boy who don't like him say, man, ain't nobody allergic to pineapples. You could eat them. And he say, my mama told me not to eat them. And they tell him, no, you can eat them pineapples, but you already know, you told him, don't eat the pineapple because you're allergic. It's going to make you sick. But the other little kid who don't like him said, you can eat them pineapples. Ain't nothing going to happen to you. That's crafty counsel. That's being sneaky. That's trying to trick your son into doing something that he shouldn't do. God said that his enemies have done the same thing. Go back to that. Read up a little.
Keep Psalms 83, verse 1. Verse 2. For lo, thy enemies make a tumult.
You have to understand, there's people who hate God. It's a lot of people that run around and say, oh, I love the Lord, I love the Lord. But genuinely and truth, they hate God. And not only that, it's other nations who know who your God is, and they hate him for not picking them. He picked you and didn't pick them.
Right.
You understand that?
And they that hate thee have lifted up the head.
So what are you saying? The ones that hate you, they have gotten uppity. They biggity right now. They feel like they winning right now. They on top. That's what lifted up the head mean. They braggadocious. They ha 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 ha. We got them now. That's how they is. Read.
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
They telling your son to eat the pineapples after you done told him don't eat the pineapples. Come on.
And consulted against thy hidden ones.
So the children of Israel are the hidden ones. They're the ones who the children of Israel are pretty much hidden from themselves. Because the rest of the world know who you are. That's the. This is the crafty counsel that they're taking. They're telling you that you're not who you are. And they know that that's who you are. Read. But I'm going to show you what crafty counsel that they playing against you right now. Come on.
They have said, come, let us cut them off from being a nation.
So God is telling us that, hey, they cutting off the children of Israel from being a nation. One, telling you that you're not this people. And two, they're going to tell you things that you should do that's against God. That's going to keep you cut away from him. That's going to keep you from receiving and the understanding of what God wants from you. Read.
1 Timothy 2 verse 9. In like manner also that women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
All right, so guess what? Sister, I ain't even finna try to, but I want you to know something. God said that the women of Israel, they are supposed to adorn themselves in modest apparel. You know what modest means? Huh? No, not here. Modest means not drawing sexual attention. Right? So the crafty counsel is, let's open up a store, we're gonna call it Rainbow. We're gonna call it Forever 21. We're gonna call it Rule 21. And then we're gonna push tight form-fitting clothes on the so-called black and Hispanic women and Native American women. They like that, because guess what? They men lustful. So if they put this on, it's gonna make the men lust after them, and then it's gonna be less marriages but more sex, which means more sin. You understand that? You do what I said? More sin. So lustfulness is gonna make sin. Tight clothes on women and revealing clothes on women is gonna make the man lust after her. He's gonna look at you for sexual attention. He's not gonna look at you for your spirit and seeing what kind of woman that you are. He's not gonna wanna get to learn and know what kind of person you are before he wants to have sex with you. Read that again from the top.
In like manner also, that women adore themselves in modest apparel.
So guess what? Right now, you actually halfway there, because you have on a dress. God requires that the women of Israel wear dresses and skirts. Hold that what you got, Deuteronomy 20:25. But we're gonna come back to this, and we're gonna show you how you can fix it, how you can get in order with God, because you don't wanna die here, right? You don't want to die here. I mean, you don't know. You can say it with confidence. I don't want to die here. Because guess what? That's a part of us making sure. Hold that Philippians 2:12. Make your calling and election sure. Because guess what? Guess what? You have to say that thing with confidence, because that's a part of changing. It's like if you get up in the morning and you say, I'm going to get me a job today. Don't you work harder at getting a job? You ever had to look for a job? Yeah, so the day that you get up and you say, I'm going to get me a job today, you don't just go out there and be like, I hope somebody hires me. You go and you be like, you got applications? I'm going to fill it out right here. You got an application? I'm filling it out right here. If you don't do that thing confidently and you say, I guess I'm going to get a job, guess what you might do? You might just scroll on your phone for about 15 minutes and say, I looked. So you got to have confidence. You got to be sure. And when you start making the decision, read.
Philippians 2 verse 12, wherefore, my beloved, as ye have also obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling.
So you got to have confidence when you're getting ready to make the decision. Deuteronomy 20:25. So we're going to show you how to keep modest apparel. So going forward, every day from this day forward, you can have it in your mind that I am a princess of the nation of Israel, and I gotta keep myself in a certain way. Read.
Deuteronomy 22 verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
God said you can't wear what a man wear, and you already doing the right part of it. You already halfway there, because you're not wearing pants like a man. You're not cross-dressing to look like a man. So guess what? You should give yourself give yourself a mental pat on the back, like, okay, I'm wearing what God said that I'm supposed to wear. But now I gotta fix it. I gotta make sure that I do it the right way.
neither shall a man put on a woman's garment. For all that do so are an abomination unto the Lord thy God.
So sister, you don't want to be something that's abominable to the Most High God. You don't want to just stop and be like, hey, I'm halfway there. You want to be all the way there, sister. Go ahead, 1 Timothy 2 and 9. Just listen before you walk away, because it ain't to tear you down. It's to make sure you get it right. It's just like if you was putting a decimal point in the wrong spot. You got all the math right, but you put the decimal point in the wrong spot. The problem wrong, but you got the right math. We just want to make sure you put the decimal point in the right spot.
Read 1 Timothy 2, verse 9. In like manner also, that women adorn themselves in modest apparel with shamefacedness and sobriety.
So God says, black woman, Hispanic woman, Native American woman, be modest in your going. Don't be outside all in everybody's face, half naked. Don't be all in everybody's face, loud, smoking loud, smelling like alcohol, like you done popped a pill. He says shamefaced it and sobriety. That means you're not loud in everybody's face.
Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.